declaring NAFTA to customs. So the way you do it is you go to the CBP form 7501, and you make a declaration by placing symbol CA for Canada or MX for Mexico, depending where it comes, which NAFTA member it comes from, on the CBP form 7501 in the column which is before the HTS line item appropriate for that particular commodity. Corrections must be made within 30 days after discovery. And the key here is a calendar day. So if you discover that there is a mistake, you have 30 calendar days to make that correction. This stuff is relevant in a case where, let's say, customs is suspecting some kind of negligence, and you're trying to show the good faith and goodwill, and you say you have a record, well, licensed customs broker have a record in the form of email or some other form of communication where you have a statement saying we found out this to be an error. And it was corrected within 30 days. So it was a mistake of fact, if you will, not tantamounting to negligence, therefore not calling for the penalty action as we discovered that can be applicable for negligence under the section 163.6 of the 19 CFR Code of Federal Regulations. All right, so how do customs examiners test on this? This is straightforward stuff. You just need to remember the number of days and the type of days, because customs regulations they bifurcate the days into the two types. One is business day, also called a working day, which excludes weekends and holidays. Another one is a calendar day, which pretty much includes the all the days on the calendar. All right, so let's take a look. After filing a claim for preferential treatment of the goods under NAFTA upon importation through formal declaration, so you have a formal entry, and a U.S. importer has how many days to revise the declaration based on erroneous information? And here it's a pretty straightforward answer. You just need to make sure that you know what's going on. You have erroneous information that needs to be corrected, and the core of the question: how many days to make an amendment. Notice a formal declaration. It doesn't have to be formal as long as there is a as long as there is an NAFTA claim. So even if it's informal entry claiming NAFTA, and recall, informal is given a more lax procedure. So informal refers to commercial merchandise under $2,500, and it also refers to personal shipments. You also may get a waiver. Also, usually, generally given to commercial merchandise $2,500 or less. But you may just make a statement instead of execution of the CBP form 434, NAFTA certificate of origin. But so this is really not the punchline. The punchline here is that erroneous information was given, and it needs to be revised. Keep in mind that erroneous information does not have to disqualify the preferential treatment. It may just change the formula a little bit, even though if it was disqualified, even though it was not disqualified, that the call of the question is on erroneous information, not on disqualifying provision. So even though you made a mistake, let's say, in calculating the attributable net cost value amount, you still under obligation under the regulations to make that disclosure within 30 calendar days. Of course, most of the questions would deal with disqualifying portion as opposed to the portion that qualifies as a portion which is merely ministerial or doesn't have the effect on the NAFTA.